Here is a pretty substantial piece of steel that will be the housing for the spindle. I will need to go through multiple setups here to make this work. The lathe isn't too big, and I need to turn both the outside and inside and all the sides and everything.
Yes, I have been busy designing a new spindle for my lathe. Totally unnecessary, I guess, but you have to do something. There are several things that can be improved on this lathe. One thing is to get rid of the gearbox, and that is what I hope to do with this spindle. There is a spindle, there is a housing, and there are some bearings inside. Let me show you. So you can see here, bearing, and the shaft. Back here, that will be a pulley for the belt I use. And if we look here in the front of the spindle here, we see clearly the bearings. And the next big thing is that is the sealing here. I have used the labyrinth seal here, so there is no rubber seal or non-contacting seal. So the idea is that by the centrifugal force, liquids and all other stuff, they go up into this channel and kind of find its way down there where it is poured out or leaked out. There are a number of screws to fasten the front disc here to the housing, and these screws out here, they are the mounting screws for the spindle to any bracket, so you will need to make a bracket to mount it onto the lathe. Yeah, there is a lot of things to do here, and I think it will be a handful for my little lathe, but we will see how it turns out. And if you stick around, you will have the opportunity to see a lot of bad machining practices. As always, this is not a tutorial. It is just me doing things, and I'm showing that on YouTube. Take it for what it is. This job is probably more than what my little lathe can handle here, but we will see what we can do. The spindle housing is made from a solid piece here because that is what I had. It would be better to have a hollow piece, but I don't have that. If you just look at the different components here, we have the housing, which I will start with today, and the other major components, that is the spindle shaft with the bearing seats, and well, there are bearing seats in the housing also. We have the grooves for the labyrinth seals to make, and there is 1, 2, 3, 4, what shall I call them, discs that need to be made as well. So there is a lot of turning. I don't have very good materials to start with, as usual, so there will be a lot of rough turning to make them into rough sizes. Yeah, let it start.
First I need to make a hole in the middle here so I can support the piece by the live center. And to do that, I need to bring it up here, and I will use a steady rest here. So let's see how that turns out. And as I say, it's pretty substantial. How about that? The rest sits nice. Now I need to center it up here. Very neat there with a... Well, there isn't much lining up to do there. Just a little go. Yeah, there is a good centering hole. It kind of went quiet here when I added some oil. Just kind of made its job already. Wonder if I will learn to screw those screws in the right direction. Thank you. Yeah, that was pretty revealing, I think, here. I will change the insert to an insert with a positive cutting angle. Let's see if that works out better. Pro tip, don't have oil on the workpiece. You will get oil smoke in the whole building. Anyways, it looks fine here. It could be more shiny, but the texture looks awesome, really. That's it for the live center then. Well, I think it kind of works, but it's not very forced. Maybe I should just drill a hole in the middle there. I'll try one more time here. No, too long stick out there. Well, I think I just make it difficult for myself. I will make a hole in the middle there. We like peck drilling, right? No problem there. That went well. So with that I can just do a standard outwards facing here. I'll start by going in 10 millimeters. Well, I think it works. It is slow, but it works. I'll just continue. So it's just 12 millimeter in there. Yeah. Well, what options do I have? I have to continue. Millimeter in. It goes okay. I will just continue. Well, it was all right. No, it was not all right. It was not all right. It couldn't go any further in there. I felt there wasn't chips enough produced there. I had it too close there. There are some extra millimeters there that should do it. Start boring. I will just make two light cuts up here to 31 millimeter. It should now be on 30, so let's see. More. I'll replace that tip there. Yeah, 70 millimeter. There is a lot of vibrations here. Not too worried about that. I think I can fix that later on. It makes nice short chips though. So I can keep it like that. But a spring pause, we need to do a spring pause. Oops. Perhaps a little bit better. One more. And the problem that is really this long stick out here. So when it comes to making the bearing positions here, I will shorten this one. Have it as short as possible. That should take away the vibrations. And I have a hold 70, that is 30 millimeter deep. Shall I try with outward facing? I can do that. Yeah, that was much better. I can go faster, I can take bigger cuts, and there are no vibrations, so I'll keep on with this. I'll just have to reposition the camera again. I will just check if I can do a slightly longer cut. Yeah, that works out fine. Yeah, let's face it, it will take some time this. Well, it seems that the tool loader here with the bar, it kind of rotated a bit here, so it doesn't have the right dimension out here. So I will do a new shortcut here to measure in the tool again, and then one more pause. So final linear diameter here should be 74.5. I will now do a cut here again to go up to 73. Oh, same problem as before, but now there are a lot of chips in between here. Made it impossible for it to go the full way in. I will start that. It will end up in the final position anyway. So. Oops. There it was in the bottom. Don't need to go in there so much, obviously. Oh, it got itself. Oh, ho, ho. That was surprising. First real failure. So, can I get it out here, or do I need to take it down on the bench? Got it. Everything is quite a bit warm here now, so maybe I should rest for the rest of the day. So now the steady rest is fixed again. I will rough out here for the cylindrical roller bearing out here, and that will be the final thing for today. And again, again, again. No, I tried with that other bit there, but that wasn't a good idea. No, that doesn't make sense. I will give up on this long bar for the time being. This will be a very slow cut. I will start to see if I can get rid of the shatter marks here. Yeah, there was shatter, but did it create more or did it reduce? I'm not sure. There's still a lot. That's for sure. Another even slower cut. Yeah, that made wonders on the surface finish there. There's still some minor vibration marks on it, but it is much better now. So I'll do one more pass. That should bring it up to 73.5. That actually was a little bit worse. It was better before. I'll try again. Well, I guess it's all right there, but... Well, that was just by mistake. It was 10 times too high feed rate here, but it was okay. And then it is pretty good surface here. It's a little bit rough here. And there is some shatter marks. It's not so easy. I will just make a quick check to see what happens if I use the very slow feed rate here. If it will improve the surface finish or if it will just cause shatter here. In principle, this is okay, I would say here. But I'll make a quick check here. I have a few millimeters out here I can do.
Yeah, the lathe is definitely small, but it can do it, it can do it. The rough turning of this side is now more or less finished, and it is just to continue. But that will be next time. Thanks for watching.